Blue is the color. I was looking in the mirror now, craning my neck, pulling the collar of my pajamas down, sticking out my tongue. My skin. In this light, it looks pale blue. I look into my own worried eyes, and then the next morning, the same scene, but a little bluer, a little bit more blue. My same worried eyes. This time I try and ignore my reflection as I get dressed, with slow movements. The feeling of blue rising up inside me, then sitting on the edge of the bed, slowly pulling on my socks, the curtains half open. Down the corridor I go, enter the elevator. My blue finger pressing the ground floor button. And then the slow descent to the lobby. Then crossing the warm carpet. The doorman's curious expression. Shouldering the revolving doors. Most mornings he says hello. This morning he looks worried. He's noticed my blueness, my deep, deep blue. There's no denying it. I'm turning blue. Walking through the streets with careful steps. A street sign, Lexington Avenue. Passing a yellow New York food truck with the people in a queue. Then pausing at a corner. My bony blue hand, yes, blue, wedged into my side as if to prop up myself. Catching my breath at a bookshop window, checking the reflection, seeing my own wan eyes, the suffocated cardiovascular pallor, the troubled glances of passers-by, the whispers, he's so blue. The books on display in the bookshop window, a picture of Egon Schiele, strangely reminiscent of my own countenance and my naked self I saw in the mirror this morning. On I go with painfully slow steps. I wonder how long. I wonder, people overtaking me on the pavement. The subway station, the sign showing colorful circles of the metro line and the letters white on black, 68th Street. Here I'll stand here at the top of the step, hold the railing, people hurrying up from the dark of the tunnel to my right, and others glancing past, trotting down the steps. Then, a short breath, then a hand on my shoulder, a woman in a long skirt and sandals, with three dogs on a leash. She takes my arm, leads me away, across a zebra crossing. She sits me down on a concrete bench, in front of a university, students with books passing and staring. Her voice is soft. She tells her dogs to heal. They heal. 1, 2, 3. She touches the side of my face, holds my hand. An ambulance arrives, white of the ceiling. I can't really hear their voices. I can feel my blueness becoming bluer. And the blue uniforms of the paramedics, the siren even sounds blue. Oh, I'll close my eyes if I can summon the strength. Then I open them, fluorescent light, A doctor with a stethoscope enters the room. She puts her fingers on my wrist. She unbuttons my shirt, listens to my heart. I watch her. Is that a smile? Then she checks behind my ear. I speak. Am I dying? She definitely smiles now. Not today. She goes to a basin, turns on a tap, wets a cloth, and wipes my neck, my face, my belly, my arm. I feel weak, I say. I think it's my heart. She looks up. Even her eyes are smiling. Have you bought new bed sheets recently? She says. Why, yes, I have. How did you know? Are they by any chance blue? Why, yes, they are. How? She interrupts me. Cheap sheets and sticky New York summer nights. That's my diagnosis. She holds up the wet cloth. It's all stained in blue. Later, I enter the park gates with a feeling of quiet